Alexis, the whole announced thing, like more trouble for the GFA.
Charlie, yawa day. Because if you look at the whole ramifications of what's happening right now, and you get a bigger understanding of what is supposed to happen, you weep for all the souls in Ghana football. It tells you that there's been a lot of rot that's going on in the fraternity of football, the greed, the corruption, the kind of money laundering, mm-hmm. and the levels to which it's gone on for quite some time now shows that Ghana football is worse off than it's been over the last century. This wasn't the kind of football authority that Kwame Nkrumah, when he was building the nation with Ohenejan, was looking for it. So
exactly.
This doesn't represent us in any good light, and it leaves us in a very, very bad place.
Well, certainly. I think it leaves us in a very, very bad light, because a lot of people do not understand the magnitude of this thing and how this thing can go. I think Anas did a fantastic job, not just touching on football, but also touching on the National Sports Authority that handles athletics, handles basketball, volleyball, swimming, whatever sport in Ghana. It could also lead to, say, the IAAF banning Ghana for doing some very shrewd business, trying to get people to foreign lands and seek greener pastures, I should say. Over the weekend, I was talking to one of the guys of the executive committee, and he was telling me that there are people in the executive committee who really didn't like what Kwesi Nyantechi was doing. And my point was that, so why didn't they speak up when Kwesi Nyantechi was still president of the association? And why didn't they all come out to tell us that this is wrong, that is wrong, and that is wrong? When the Xylophone cash deal came out, and we were asking questions about how much money was in that thing, nobody came out to tell us anything. They told us there was a confidentiality clause in there. I mean, when Barclays announced their sponsorship deal with the English Premier League,
everything was
out there. Yeah. Greg Clark came out categorically and told them how much they were earning and all of that. I think what the GFA lacked in Kwesi Nyantechi's tenure was transparency and a bit of arrogance in there, because Nyantechi actually felt at a point that he was untouchable, and there were several times when he granted interviews saying "Omotai Munsoni" and all of that, and that he is the. It's like it felt like a birthright for him to become FA president and stay there for a long time.
There were deep layers to the corruption. There were deep layers to the greed. There were deep layers to the arrogance. Kwesi Nyantechi, in several ways, showed you that he had used several years to be able to amass the kind of influence and power for him to be able to detect things to the people involved in football fraternity. And like you rightly said, if you see the kind of rot that happens in not just football, but in various sections of our sports fraternity, it goes to show you that for a very long time now, we are going to find trouble fixing all of the mess that we find ourselves in right now. Exactly. For me, like we always say, Yawadi, but this is Yawadi, actually. You don't some extra level. Yawadi.
No, they all be really extra. Because, I mean, a lot of people don't understand the whole thing. But just to clarify, I mean, the government has not dissolved the Ghana Football Association. They were just taking steps to do that. And from what we learn now, the FA working close with government to try to clean the system and get people in there. Now, CEO Kofi Boakye, who is one of the astute, policemen in Ghana, the man has solved several crime issues, has been put as the head of the ethics committee to fight some of these things. So it's going to be an interesting next few days, next few weeks, next few months, next year when the FA is supposed to go for elections. Right now that they do not have a president, I'm sure the elections will come really close, probably by the end of the year, there should be a new FA president.
In terms of the PR relations, they haven't been able to get in front of this crisis to be able to...
I was going to ask you about it. Now, when Nyantechi was taken to the CID, I mean, the FA's main Twitter account didn't tweet about it. Is it a personal account? Or it's for the Ghana Football Association. I'm sure you as a social media person and all of that, you could tell us a bit more about it.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of crisis management, you need to be able to be a bit sure and being able to handle the situation when it comes forward, because you deliberately avoiding the issue means that you are not able to jump in front of us.
If government had dissolved the Ghana Football Association, what it have meant for Ghana is that, there were lots of footballing activities that we could not participate in. Every football activity, really, from the Black Stars to the Black Queens to the Black Maidens to the Black Princesses. If you look at this year alone, now Ghana plays Kenya, Sierra Leone and Ethiopia during the end of the year. there's a black maidens, there's a World Cup for the under 17 Women's World Cup coming up. There's an under 20 Women's World Cup also coming up. And for these girls who have played out their sweat and everything to be at the World Cup and for them to not be there just because of a rift, an administrative rift in the country, that could be a very big problem for them.
Again, it goes back to the whole issue of who comes in to clean this mess, who comes in to clean this rot, who comes in to give us assurance that, for instance, Ghana football is going to be able to rise from this field to be able to take part in like global games, like you've been able to rightly say. So, for instance, in my own estimation, I think that Tony Balfour is a person that we can look forward to coming up and being the man to take charge of this whole thing, because it's somebody who is clean, somebody who has a deep understanding of what we should be doing, and someone who's been involved in FIFA and football for a very long time. He has the financial understanding and the full administrative football sense to be able to get us out of this mess.
Well, I mean, it's interesting that you've mentioned Tony Balfour. He rightly is an experienced person. Yeah. I mean, I was watching Spain, Netherlands the last time, the World Cup final in 2010, and the man was sitting on the bench, you know, as a match commissioner and all of that. It made me really proud to be Ghanaian and all of that. But several other names have also come up. But what the GFA is saying is that they do not want someone outside the Ghana Football Association. And that's what I find really interesting. They want someone who has been with the Ghana Football Association for some time, knows the ranks, knows how things work at the Football Association. And for that reason, they've mentioned someone like CEO of Dreams FC, Keto Kreku. They've also mentioned Anabe Ineisen, who is already in the Ghana Football Association. And also Kojo Yanka, who is Western Regional FA Chairman. So these are names that have come up. And it will be interesting, really, because someone like for someone like Kurt, you know, we've already heard that he's interested in the position of being Ghana Football Association boss and all of that. Looking at how he has run the MTN FA Cup, how he has been actively involved in the Ghana Premier League and all of that. I mean, he looks like one of the men who might get a post and can do a job for the Ghana Football Association. So guys, that's it for Tackle. Watch us on YouTube at 3Extra and subscribe to the channel as well. And follow us on Twitter at 3SportsGH.
My name is Lexus.
And my name is Kawawa.